we tell her where to go?
It's not far.
Go on.
Look up. Just up there. Listen to us. Is it?
Should we talk to
her? Shall we?
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a girl, isn't she?
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart.
What is it?
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't.
Turn back. Turn back. It's dangerous.
Jesus.
What's it?
A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop you.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua, it's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a plan.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
I can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I should want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
She'll have to go.
She has to.
You have to rest here.
Lighting the torch.
It's not gonna help her.
She's lighting the fire.
It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here? Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Tilly. Thank you.
The dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rhaen would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. So Rhaen reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rhaen go in search of Fafnir.
What's she doing? She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. Now the darkness will swallow you.
Where is she going?
Faster, keep going. Faster, keep going. Stop.
Nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Keep the torch alight.
Thank you.
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. All about you.
Listen.
I've been to death. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me to the mountain.
To trust you.
As deep as we can go.
I want